They are in the final. Played three and they're on 7 points. Now, Ali McCoist is having a very, very good night. Leading scorer here at the Scottish Masters with 4. He and Rangers are up against Dundee United next, who've had Alex Taylor on target for them tonight. Rangers Dundee United is next. It's the Scottish Masters. Just a reminder, it was a long time in coming, but it had to happen. I've just been struck by the football. The crowd liked it. You can vote for your player of the tournament tonight by calling 0900 9100 234. That's 0900 9100 234. If you're the lucky caller and you get through and you become the winner, then you're going to Wembley to the British Masters final in October. And you can also win the signed jersey of tonight's player of the tournament. Well, it's been a great night for Hearts. They are in tonight's final. They played three and they're on 7 points. So who'll join them in the final? It will be either Rangers or Dundee United. Their next up, alongside Jim Proudfoot, is John Robertson.
Thanks, Jim. Good shot, wasn't it? With 263 international caps and 33 international goals between them, it's not hard to see why Rangers just need a draw for a place in the final. Those names ooze experience and ooze honours. United's Billy Kirkwood will be desperate to stop Rangers and Mark Hatley in particular. He was Hatley's number two when the pair of them were the management team at Hull City. Well, David Dodds could be forgiven for having mixed loyalties for this one, as well as being part of the championship winning side with United. He was also a coach at Rangers for 4 years. Trevor Stephen, who played under Dodds, is one of the members of the Rangers side beaten by the Terrors in the 1994 Scottish Cup final. Well, the equation is quite simple for this one. A victory for Dundee United, and they're playing Hearts in the final. Anything else, and it's Hearts against Rangers. John Robertson, I think I can gather who you might want to meet in the final, these two.
Well, it doesn't matter. It's going to be a very hard game anyway, but we played well against United. We obviously withdrew with Rangers, but Hearts boys are just delighted to be there.
Nice. Dundee United on the early attack. And that, not the sort of shot that they were hoping for. It did seem at one stage in that last game, John, as though quite a few people in your side might have a little bit of money on you being the tournament's leading scorer, passing to you at every opportunity in front of goal.
Yeah, there's a couple of chances there, but I'd be very surprised if we take over from that Rangers number 10 there. I'm sure about 90% of the votes are already in for the man of the tournament, Mr. McCoist, with his usual hat-trick.
4 goals that he's got so far as he runs forward onto the pass from Pritz. Hatley ahead of him, still McCoist, now Nicol. In towards the feet of McCoist. United can bring it away with Dodds finding Bannon. This is better from the Terrors. Ball was intended for Dodds but didn't quite find its way through from the ball from John Holt. Still they maintain possession though. Bannon back to Dodds. Good effort from Dodds. The first shot on target of this final game. Easily read by Nicky Walker. Good turn by Hatley. Bowman coming back to put the pressure on. This is Pritz. McCoist sitting in a slightly deeper position than he has done for most of the night so far. Pritz once more. Holt. Hamish McAlpine just got the ball away in time, the veteran. Bannon. Stumble coming just at the wrong moment for it. Hatley able to bring the ball away for Rangers. Well, it could have gone either way after the little bit of wrestling. Does go Rangers' way. Hatley stretched and just tried to squeeze the ball past Hamish McAlpine and couldn't do it. Now McCoist tracks all the way back.
That's very unusual there. Alan McCoist will be getting a nosebleed. Managed to get that far back. You wouldn't be surprised if you put it past Nicky Walker for there.
McCoy snuck it ball for Brown. More players tumbling. Bowman. Dodds. Couldn't get hold of it as he wanted on the turn. But Dundee United, John, certainly seem to have come into this with a bit of belief.
Yeah, they're good. Very, as we say it in this tournament, a very experienced side. But no, they've all come down here, Eamon. You know, a lot of these boys are in their 40s now and they've come down to play and play well, they have.
Now Pritz. Hatley tried his luck with the left-footed curler. Couldn't quite get it to do enough to get past McAlpine. as we approach the halfway stage of this first half. It's still 0-0. That will be good enough for Rangers. Haitley makes the run forward. This is McCoist. McCoist for his fifth goal of the tournament. Good save again, McAlpine. And he's sweeping up at the back as well.
Yeah, he misses very good with his feet there, but a chance for Alan McCoist to add yet another golden boot. I think he might only need another couple.
Not bitter, Jono.
Not at all, not at all. I've had too many silver medals to him over the years.
This is Trevor Stephen there for Rangers. Coist has also got the chance to become the leading scorer for the tournament as a whole so far. That accolade currently being held by Gary Birtles, who scored 5 in the Midlands Masters in Nottingham. Coist, as we've been saying, on 4 with almost 2.5 games played so far. Gary Birtles, of course, guaranteed another chance to extend that tally of 5 because he is in the final. Coist will be hoping that Rangers are in the overall final as well, but John sitting alongside me, he's got something to say about that, I'm sure.
Well, we'll give our best shot now. As I said, we're there. That's what we came to do tonight. We wanted to reach the final, and we'll see if we can go all the way.
Rangers still to finalise their place in it, but a goal would help them a lot. Here is McCoist trying to find that again. Can't beat McAlpine, who, after a jittery opening couple of minutes in the first game, really has come into his own. He's had a good night, Hamish McAlpine. This is Taylor now. Dodds in space, and this is promising for Dundee United. And it needed a little bit of magic at the back from McGregor. Mad Dog furious with his defensive colleagues. Now the other end, Walters. Good save again by McAlpine. Still very close to call. Which way does Dundee United's David Neary see it going?
David, can you win this?
We've got to win it to stay in the championship. It's hard going, but we need to do our best.
You seem to be taking chances with David Dodds staying very far up front.
Yeah, well, he's actually struggling. He's got a calf injury just now, so just got to try and keep him up there and hopefully just play the ball up to his feet and get people to run off it.
You started very well, but it's not gone to plan since then.
Yeah, the second game we lost an early goal and we just kind of went to pieces. You know, tried chasing the game and you can't do this here. Just got to keep your shape. Hopefully we'll do that here.
Thanks for joining us.
Cheers.
Very coy, these two sides at the moment. Not wanting to give anything away, Rangers. And a little bit of amusement from Robert Fleck doing a couple of imaginary press-ups after ballooning one well over the bar.
Yeah, not like Robert there, but no, you can see it's a cagey game here, Jim, that United know they have to win it. I think they'll keep it tight and then really go for it the last 2 or 3 minutes and try and get that all-important goal.
This is Willie Pettigrew now for United. Now Bannon, certainly open things up if Dundee United were to score. Pettigrew! Couldn't do that, and again it causes problems off the ball. That was a much better touch from Fleck at the other end of the pitch. Now Walters has been one of the danger men for Rangers so far. Good cross, Jimmy Nicol couldn't quite get there in time. United again able to bring it away. Fleck, good save, and it needed saving from McAlpine. It was just creeping in.
Yeah, tremendous save from Hamish there, a good strike from Robert. But as you say, Rangers know one goal might just be enough to see them through. And Dundee United really, as we said, have to win the game. Are taking risks.
Pettigrew, still Pettigrew! 1-0 to Dundee United! And all of a sudden, Rangers are up against it. And it's the old men in the old man's tournament that get the lead.
Yeah, well, Willie Pettigrew was a man that looked after me early in my career. And that was his great secret. Hit the ball early, don't give the goalie a chance to get himself set. And that's exactly what he's did there.
Meanwhile, at the other end, Mark Walters tests McAlpine just a little bit more than he would have liked. But it's 1-0 to Dundee United, and that is enough to put them in the final against Hearts at Rangers' expense. It could be a long 8.5 minutes, though, for Dundee United to try and hold on. They'll try and get a second, though. Appeals for handball against Pritz. Referee Steve Lodge didn't want to know. Stephen now for Rangers. Pressure on the men in blue. Walters. Stephen again. Step over from Walters, but time not on Rangers' side as we approach the end of this first period. Will they get a shot in time? Pritz tries his luck. Back to Walters off the boards. Time beats Mark Walters. A little bit of a shock on the cards after the first 8 minutes of this final league game. Dundee United leading Rangers by one goal to nil. This was the goal that put them in the lead. Willie Pettigrew muscling his way past Jimmy Nicol, stinging it through the legs of Nicky Walker. Dundee United, good value for it, John Robertson.
Yeah, well, it's been a tight game, we said that. It was very coy to begin with. Rangers don't want to commit too many men forward, but now United have got the goal, the pressure swings to Rangers. Rangers have to go forward, but I'm sure United now will sit in a little bit and hit the break, because the second goal will be all important.
Well, Willie Pettigrew won the League Cup in both his seasons with Dundee United. What a goal! What a magnificent goal! Well, just as we were saying that Dundee United were desperately trying to hold on, that half-time lead lasted 3 seconds. Walters with a magnificent strike.
Well, that's just sheer class. The vision there, I don't think Hamish is happy. He's still got his training shoes in his hand. The referee hasn't given him time to get back to his goals. But Rangers won't care about that now. Controversial.
1-1 it is. Bannon at the other end. That really will spark the game into life. Walters, who has been quite sublime on occasions, a couple of wonderful runs to set up goals for McCoist in the previous games, and dare I call that Beckham-esque. Here's Fleck. Well, I was going to ask you whether you felt Rangers had to get themselves back into the game early. Didn't even have a chance to do that.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. It's a tremendous piece of vision, but I'm sure you'll see there again in the replays in the end, it could be a bit controversial because Hamish still had his training shoes in his hand and the referee didn't give him time to get back to the goal, so I don't think United will be well pleased.
Stephen, dropping that little bit deeper, and I remember in the first game that Dundee United played against Celtic, we remarked that it took Hamish McAlpine a few seconds to make the jaunt from one end of the pitch to the other. He did to his cost then. Here's Pritz, back to Walters. Walters! Another goal from the former Aston Villa man, and Rangers, who looked as though they might be heading out, have scored twice in the opening 60 seconds.
Yeah, well, that's a tremendous trick again from Mark. He's just a bag of tricks. He's been that all through his career. This game is ideally suited for him with his skills, and that really puts Rangers in the driving seat now. United will have to take risks.
Well, Mark Walters won the European Super Cup some 18 years ago when he was at Aston Villa. Just 18 years of age when he won that. Also, 10 years later, won the 1992 FA Cup with Liverpool. Honours galore in his time at Rangers. And he's turned it round single-handedly here. Rangers just needing a draw to get through to the final against Hearts. And they now lead 2-1, having trail. It's all looking good for Rangers. Robert Fleck must be a delighted man as he speaks to Chris.
Robert, you moved into top gear now.
Yeah, we're coming on now. Sticky start, we're chopping and changing about. But lads are enjoying it, so hopefully we can go to better things.
No goals from yourself so far?
No, I'm too busy defending for all the old ones in there. Because I'm the youngest in the team, they expect me to do the running. But I'm enjoying it. Mark Waters has done tremendous. McCoy has scored a couple of three goals, so it's great. It's great.
Bit controversial, the goal from Mark Walters. The goalkeeper wasn't in his goal, was there?
Oh, well, I says to Mark, I says, chip him. But once you take off, I says, chip him. And great skill. Only Mark Walters could do that out that pitch tonight. And you can't say any more about the fella. He's been tremendous.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Well, John and I just did a huge double take there as Ali McCoy's missed from about 2 feet out.
Yeah, that's not like Coyce. Well, should I say it's not like him? He has been known to miss one or two, but he normally sticks one in a couple of seconds later.
Well, this time he tries to play the killer ball through the Dundee United defence for Walters, who is on a hat-trick. Free kick goes Dundee United's way. Bowman trying to make sure he doesn't get caught in possession. The youthful legs of Dave Bowman, the youngest player in this Dundee United side, brings the ball forward. Neri. Holt. Dundee United need two to stay in the tournament. Here's Jimmy Nicol for Rangers. Hateley is in a lot of space in the centre. Now Nicol again. Pritz. Forward towards Hateley. Dundee United need something dramatic. Two goals in the last 3.5 minutes or so. That will be enough to get them in the final. And could this be the first? Good chance for Pettigrew. Good challenge by Jimmy Nicol.
Yeah, tremendous challenge there for Jimmy Nicol. It looked, for all that Willie Pettigrew was going to get there, he just couldn't get it. It'd have been a tremendous goal for the match, because it'd have made the last 3 minutes hell for leather.
Well, another goal for Rangers. Shorty kills Dundee United off now. This is John McGregor back for Nicol. He looks to supply the incisive ball and finds Robert Pritz. McCoy's in the centre, so to Haidley! Very close, didn't quite fall for McCoy off the boards either.
Yeah, Ali was in there, it was a tremendous effort from Mark, only inches past, that would have been the goal to seal it, but here come United down the other end.
With Kirkwood, pulls the ball back for Taylor. Pettigrew, always causing a nuisance inside the opposition box. Kirkwood tried his luck, but Nicky Walker got the angles right. That was a handball by Fleck. Cheeky one.
Yeah, Robert there was just using it. If he took his hand out of the way like his person, he would have been okay.
Mark Walters has been impressive though.
Yeah, very impressive. He could well be up there for the man of the two. I know Coyce scored the goals, but his skills, as Robert said, are a bit sublime.
Well, if you want to vote for the player of the tournament, the number to dial is 09-009-100-234. 09-009-100-234. You can win a VIP trip for two to the British Masters. This takes place in October, and a shirt signed by the winning player. Mark Walters could well be right up there. Here come Dundee United again. Pettigrew, angle too tight for it. That could be a decisive moment. Kirkwood tries his luck, turn towards goal. Kirkwood try to get in there again, and McGregor takes control at the back. Meanwhile, Fleck in acres of space. Rangers with three against one. Prince for Fleck, and Rangers are in the final.
Yeah, it looks all over now. They've just been patient. United, as we expected, had to take risks, and they've been caught out the back there. A bit unlucky not to equaliser. To get the equaliser, Nicky Walker, tremendous there, a couple of saves. But that third goal now, Robert's first of the tournament, means it looks like it's a Rangers final against us.
Fleck tapping it in from close range. He's the youngest player on view tonight. He's not 35 until later this year. Just let me remind you that the eligibility for these Masters tournaments, you have to be born in 1965 or earlier. Fleck born in 65, McCoy's born a few years before that, knocks it forward. He's still the top scorer in the tournament so far with four. Rangers leading 3-1. Dundee United with a minute to score three goals. They need a win to go through. Hegarty. Haven't seen an awful lot of him tonight. Decent shot from distance. Well saved by Walker once more.
1 minute left to play in this match. 1 minute.
Fleck. Maxwell. Look for the support in the centre. Fleck knocks it forward. Now McCoy's. McCoy's surely! Well, it has to go down as a good save.
It's a good save. I think Ali was eyeing up the golden boot there. I don't think Mr. Dawson in the middle will be too pleased. I think Ali, knowing the game was won, is just trying to get his personal tell up a bit, and as a paid up member of Strikers Union, quite right.
Well, Ali Dawson was waiting. But between you and Ali McCoy, you scored 626 goals for the clubs you're representing tonight, so I suppose you haven't got that far by not having that little selfish streak in and around
the
area.
Yeah, you're right there, Jim, but to be fair, I wouldn't have seen Ali Dawson standing there either.
Yeah, we noticed that. Full-time whistle blows, and it is Rangers who will be playing John Robertson and Hearts in the final. Mark Walters instigating a fantastic second-half fight-back with the sublime moment of the Masters tournament as a whole in the opening seconds of the second half. Walters with a quite brilliant chip to beat Hamish McAlpine in the opening seconds. Walters knocking the ball in towards McCoist. Walters has had a fine tournament so far. And it was Mark Walters who managed to mastermind that fight back from Rangers to get Rangers through to the final. So that means that Dundee United are out. Let's hear the views of one of those disappointed men. It's Hamish McAlpine is with Chris.
Hamish, the turning point was the goal just after half-time. How did you see it?
Shocking. The referee was absolutely ridiculous. We were walking back, we were talking to him. He never said he was going to start the game, and he let him play on. I think that's absolutely ridiculous.
So it shouldn't have been allowed?
Never should have been allowed. We weren't even ready to start the game. Normally he'll go to the two goalkeepers were ready to start the game. What did he do? Nothing. Shocking.
So it's cost you, really?
Cost us, yeah. We were cruising the game 1-0, they've got to chase the game. We're looking not bad. Yeah. All of a sudden you're chasing the game, they've got the impetus, they're on the go.
Unlucky, Hamish.
Thanks very much. Very angry.
Well, Hamish McAlpine is not happy. He says that the Walters goal should not have stood. It has, and Rangers will contest the final with Hearts. Let's just recap briefly on the results tonight here at the Scottish Masters at Brayhead. We get Celtic 1, Dundee United 3, Rangers 2, Hearts 2, Dundee United 1, Hearts 4, Celtic 2, Rangers 4, Celtic 1, Hearts 3, and Rangers 3, Dundee United 1. So at the end of that, Hearts and Rangers both tied on 7 points, and they will contest tonight's final. Then came Dundee United, who were not happy about that Mark Walters goal. And lastly, Celtic, and a disappointing night for Celtic and Murdoch MacLeod and company. So, no matter what, it's a Rangers-Hearts final. They will contest the final tonight. And that could end up being the battle of the sharpshooters. Ali McCoy has had a really good night here tonight. He's been on the ball, and so too has John Robertson of Hearts. Both of them will be playing for their side in tonight's final from the Scottish Masters.
Present the trophy to Mark Hateley, the victorious captain. Rangers delighted with a 4-2 victory, and McCoist inevitably at the heart of it. That put them 3-2 up. They've blown a 2-goal lead in the first half, but there was no mistake once McCoist struck again. His second of the match made it 4-2 and made it safe. Hearts always chasing the game, and from then on, Rangers could control it quite comfortably.
As told in the end, young legs, they may have had Hearts, but they didn't have the quality of McCoist and Walters. It was great to see. Good performance.
What is it about McCoist? We've said it so often. He just has a Midas touch, doesn't he?
He's a big game player, there's no doubt about that. And once they got their head on tonight, Rangers, there was no stopping them.
Who else impressed? I think Hateley took the eye, so too Walters.
Yeah, Robert Fleck did a lot of hard work in the middle of the park there. As you said, it's not his natural position, but he moved up and down really well, and then even weighed in with a goal in the final.
I think at the end of the day, they're going to Wembley, and they could well end up British Masters. Would you go with that? They seem a good unit.
Well, there's lots of good sides in this competition. We can't preempt it just yet, but that's not a bad side. Real quality in there. Trevor Stephen played ever so well tonight. We missed him out.
Disappointment for Hearts, because you tipped them before the tournament. They almost did it.
That was a kiss of death, Jim. You could have bet against them. No, they did all right. Robertson in up front was there every time the ball came across. It just didn't come across enough at the end.
What about Dundee United? Decent team. You just couldn't push through.
Yeah, David Neary's men started really, really well, and Paul Egerty very well to start with. But they just run out of legs, and Celtic, too many old legs to start with.
Too many old legs for Celtic. So at the end of the day, a thoroughly enjoyable night. And I think what has come through again, Chris, is these players enjoy playing in this tournament.
They enjoy it and the desire to win. Andy Walker said they didn't really want to win it, but I'm sure they did.
Fantastic. Rangers have won the Scottish Masters tonight here at Brayhead Arena in Glasgow. We hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for being with us from Chris Kamara and me. It's bye for now.
Had been away, haven't changed, had much to say, but man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. Told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy.